the Templar Assassin and Sven, and the Spiritbreaker can definitely mess with them by charging through them in these fights. So I like the Spiritbreaker pickup quite
a gank worthless.
Charge on the Seal Kid. They've gotten him isolated. Misrange there, but it doesn't matter. Seal Kid will still end up falling. The kill will go to Yoki. First blood for him. I would say definitely worth it.
With it, the Radiant Observer Award shows the Queen of Pain, and this is the bush that they're going to check. They're going to be looking for an opportunity to jump, and Silent takes the high ground.
So we see the save skill points of Sven going into the maxed out graded cleave. We do have the, well, there goes the ultimate swap out. Silent going to be saved. Always want to fly. Torn to bits. They are going to be able to be chased by Ninjas in Pajamas. Nice light strike array. They get off the ultimate from Resolution. Trying to pop Eric. Gets him too. That is going to be very nicely played by Resolution. And Yoki coming in trying to go for the kill on Hanskin. And he'll get it too, but it may cost him his life as he's fighting into three different other heroes. He ends up dying. Triple kill for Limp. And that was an engagement that Empire not
Aloha Dance cast the Laguna Blade on a full HP refraction TA. So that was pretty useless.
Yeah. Oh, nice combination here. The counter ward actually blocking out the ancient stack and also giving vision of whether or not there's a ward there. Yonasumpan gonna be found here, stunned up, light strike array, burst him down, but Nipar here with reinforcements. They've already thrown out the stun out of Resolution. Nice dodge with the old scepter. Can he actually get out with the stun on the limb? Glimpse back. Era's there with the damage. They're gonna try and go to Resolution, but it's too much confusion. The swap out, Era ends up dying with the mask madness out active. Well, Limp barely gets off the refraction, trying to get away from Silent. The stuns are gonna come out. Hodgkin's done for. He's gonna be left behind. Silent wants some more. Blink four gets the stun. Limp, two more refraction charges, one more refraction charge. The bash goes out and they get the kill. Farther up, the last hero alive is going to be the Ogre Magi, but he is not going to be alive for very long as he's chased down. Ultra kill for Resolution. Wow. And Yonasumpan is left with a question mark on his head. What do I do?
This is going to be a pretty tough game for them. I mean, Queen of Pain's still level 9. I think that's one really big issue, is they're just, their overall experience for their team is weak. Like, if Ogre had a bunch of levels, that would be bloodlust for all these carries. The TA, the Sven hitting hard. Instead, one shot.
No, Resolution not going to be able to pop Seal Kid right away, but the support obviously is there. And the Requiem of Souls is good enough zoning to make sure that Nipper not going to go in. Oh, Light Strike Array going to land on Yonasumpan. They have the damage necessary to get the double kill for Resolution. Now the charge forward. Limp going to be caught here by F-Fly damage, plus the right clicks, bash, and greater bash. They've got them all. Empire locked down that Templar Assassin damn easily, and it seems Burns fights as best as he can. He split pushed pretty heavily, got that tower quite low. He was actually intending to push down that tower with the rest of his team. Countered the split push at bottom lane, but now they're
actually just going to go
for a straight out fight. Hanskin's going to be the first target. Era can go for the stun here on Yoki. They're actually going to go burst down Silent first. Support for a core so far as Yoki's now going to fall as well. Yule Scepter onto one, but it's not going to be enough to save Yoki, it seems. He finally dies to Era. Right clicks, Aloha Dance going to be the next target. Light Strike Array doesn't actually land. Kills Yonasumpan actually, so it does land exactly as intended. Aloha Dance well played, but Empire throwing away some getting an MKB anytime soon. They're actually going to try and sneak in Roshan for themselves. Empire are going for a smoke gank. If they get near the Roshan pit, they'll know what's happening. Always want to fly. Go in. Wave of Terror reveals. Nip now? Question mark. Do they continue to go for it? The charge is coming in. They make the jump. Roshan's getting low. Manera's already being blown up. Lynn is trying to steal the Aegis, but he's not going to be able to get it. Oh, he snatches it. Resolution. No one can pick it up in time. Limp is going to be able to survive a bit longer on the left-hand side, though. They've already blown up the rest of Nip. Limp is going to be left alone. He gets a couple of kills there inside the pit, but it's now him and Aloha Dance. Or him versus Aloha Dance and Silent. Life number one goes down. I don't think they can go for life number two. Life
they shouldn't,
away.
But they're gonna.
They're gonna try for it. The refraction goes off. Chain stunning him down with the amplify damage. They do get the damage enough to kill him. Nicely played. Triple kill for Aloha Dance. Templar Assassin, though, snatching that Aegis.
It could be.
Do you agree with Hanskin's choice to go for a Ghost Scepter over trying to rush the Aghanim Scepter? 5-man smoke hold up here. Nip are going to be able to find an opening here. Always want to fly the first target. Empire, again, another smoke gank, and all they got was the Vengeful Spirit. Or did they? Yoki brought back with a glimpse. Silent makes the initiation on it, too, with the BKB activated. He's trying to lock down Era as best as possible. Era pops to the ultimate and now says, you want a man fight me? Let's go. Ultimate goes out. Laguna play. No, it doesn't go through refraction. Why? Resolution fighting underneath that ultimate of the Static Storm, but will not be able to survive against the two damage shields. Oh, my God. He got off the ultimate. He gets the triple kill with it. Whoa! Ninjas in pajamas do not manage to take out the...
Be able to close it out in about 500 gold, but even then, he's going to be the one to need the heart. And the fact that Slaughter can hold that over his head, have that item advantage, it helps. Now they go for the Roche, they will pick up the Aegis. There's a lot to fight into now. Three Templar Assassin Traps, the Kinetic, the Static, that AoE Stormhammer, and the Sonic Wave off cooldown thanks to the Axe Scepter.
Man, these like static pushes are so hard to deal with, and you got amplified damage going in. They're gonna jump on a Lip again. They want to be able to take out this Templar Assassin, trying to lock him down. Mike Strike Array and everything being blown, but it's not enough. Instead, they get the kill on Era. Bash up, Lip fighting up against Silent. He's winning this engagement until Resolution comes back. Silent on the way out, but no, he's not able to make it away. Era comes back with his buyback. Will take out. Always want to fly, or really, the Scotty slowing him down. The right clicks, and he's actually living. The poison tick, tick, tick. Meanwhile, Hanskin. He's actually going to be able to get himself away. Finally, Adventurous Spirit dies. Resolution forced back into the glimpse. Era right on top of him, hits the stun. There's nothing they can do to save their SF, it seems. In fact, when Lina tries to get close, she immediately dies to Yonis. Oh god, not again. Resolution gets off the ultimate. These are going to decrease their damage. Silent's now back, and he's fighting up against Yonis. Some fun. Couldn't get the damage necessary. Resolution glimpses back again a secondary time as he blows up in front of Hanskin's face, but not enough damage to get the kill. And Silent...
In the end, it's got to be just the perfect kinetic static. It's got to be Empire committing and clumping up, and that's when NIP can strike. They have to make this fight perfect because they don't have buybacks to fall back on three of their heroes.
Silent, the first target here. Yule Scepter glimpse back. Silent, a bit controlled, but Seal Kid's actually going to go down for free here. They turn around Sonic Wave, but now Limp is actually being controlled. He may actually go down. He can't afford this. Jump in, Silent, trying to get those last right clicks. A refraction save. He lives. Mount Strike to dodge, and now Era's going to go down instead. All the hype over Templar Assassin living, but it doesn't matter when now Era's dead. They've taken another. Lina with the buyback. Empire going to fully commit to this one. Can the Templar Assassin come back and win this for them? Resolution lifts off the ultimate. Hanskin definitely goes down. Queen of Pain and Templar Assassin fighting up against four members of Empire. Silent is low, but certainly not low enough. Yule Scepter, Light Strike Array, Limp. Gonna be taking a lot of damage here. Further control goes out, and that's gonna be it. Nip have no more buybacks. 100 seconds on the Queen of Pain, 80 seconds on the Templar Assassin, and there it is. GG, well played. Empire will take game five. The best of five winner bracket finals goes to Team Empire. They are coming to Germany.
Very, very well played by them. I mean, like, if you just look at the graph of Empire's victory, you can see that they were just so much less shaky when it came down to holding their victory. They were able to take not only take the advantage, but make sure that they didn't throw it away unnecessarily at any step. And that was just a perfect movement from them, even when...